Okay, here we are back with that Poulan front tine tiller, which is basically the same as the MTD or Craftsman. When we were last here, we had a gear case that was completely destroyed, or a chain case, whatever you want to call it. And that's where we left that last video. It's a couple weeks later, and I haven't been messing with it at all because it was completely destroyed. I was contemplating not messing with it at all, but I did go ahead and I just spent the last couple hours straightening this case out. And we got it pretty straight. It was bent, cracked, and I mean real bent. It took me a couple hours trying to figure out what it was supposed to look like and then beating on it on the anvil. But I did get it straightened out. I got it functioning correctly, as far as I can tell. Now I'm wishing I'd gone ahead and put the grease in it before I stuck it back together, but it will come apart. And that's what it looks like once it's cleaned up on the inside. This case was in real bad shape. It had contours that I thought were factory contours that were turned out to be contours I put in it by letting it bounce a few times. Take my advice, don't let your front tine tiller bounce because you're bending the hell out of that case. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stick some grease in here and put it back together. I'm gonna run out of grease in my little grease gun here, and I'm just gonna slather a bunch of grease in there. I haven't welded up the case yet. I'm gonna put it back together and then weld whatever needs welding. But I got it pretty straight. I had I'm not going to put a whole lot of grease in here because honestly, I don't think it needs a bunch. In fact, I'm going to put less grease in here than I thought I was. It just doesn't spin all that fast. So I'm just gonna slather the grease in there and stick it together. Call it good enough. Now I did pull the rivets out of these to try and get this out of here so I could straighten that case a little easier. And I only did the one side, riveted it back together after I straightened the case. Honestly, those sprockets and chains are plenty heavy duty. The whole machine's plenty heavy duty, but this crappy little sheet metal chain case, that's the weak link. If you let it bounce a few times, you will bend that. I didn't know that. Yeah, I bent it. It might have come a little bent when I bought it used, but I'm pretty sure it don't take much. Pretty sure it don't take much to bend it. I'm not gonna spend too much time greasing that up. I think that's enough. I kind of quit on it because I reached a point where I couldn't figure out how to get these off. So I couldn't really get to it. So I popped those rivets out of there and ground them off, went to pull that ring. The ring wouldn't come off because it stuck behind this. And I said, well, they must have press fit that on there. I'm not saying I'm brilliant. I'm just saying that's what I thought. They must have press fit that because I can't get it off and it stuck behind that deal. Well, turns out that deal is just a grease cap with a grease seal in it. It slips right over the shaft and over this deal. So, caused myself some grief there not knowing what was going on, but I finally got that off, got that apart, got that all straight. Off my finger here. Here we go again. Well, if it ain't one mistake after the other. Off one more time. It'll take just a moment to put the rest of the pieces in there. So maybe we don't have to crack it back open when we get done here. All right, I think that's everything this time. Ahead and stick this in here for right now to hold this in place while I recrimp those seams. Now, y'all saw me in that last video with that torch. was burning the heck out of everything. Well, turned out we didn't mess anything up. That didn't hurt a thing. Didn't get the seals hot enough to mess them up, and there's only two seals on there anyways. I'm gonna use this to hold this together for the time being, but this has to bolt back to the frame through there. Not sure why they had to involve that in the frame, but they did. Big. Put these bolts in here just to hold it together while I recrimp those sides. Now I'm gonna try and recrimp those sides without the heat. Maybe we can, maybe we can't. We're gonna find out. Smack that one time too many. I wasn't sure whether or not we were going to be able to help this chain case or not, so I wasn't as careful with it as I could have been. I really didn't have anything to lose. Now I'm going to pay for some of that sloppiness on reassembly, but shouldn't be too big a deal. In the back of my mind, I was thinking that I was going to be able to get it fixed. But honestly, it was in such bad shape, I wasn't at all sure. Now, be careful with that because I'm going to want to pull it off in a minute. See it, things kind of working. And I think it's going to work just fine. So, get back to that problem later. All right. Now, what we're going to do is see if we can't recrimp this. Without the heat. In fact, I'm just going to pull out my little anvil here and see how it goes. See what happens here. Maybe we'll wind up using heat. I don't know. Ought to put me some tack welds on there. Maybe we can get away with this. Just fine, but you get a little bit of a pain in the ass. But the whole thing's been a pain in the ass, so the point is, I think we will manage to get it fixed. Like Pterodactyl says, it ain't the space shuttle, it's a garden tiller. And honestly, at the end of this video, I'm gonna show you why I don't really care if I get it fixed or not. But here's the thing. We wanna know if we can fix it. This thing was beyond repair. And by that I mean a reasonable person would have thrown it on a trash pile, and got a better plan. However, for a couple hours the other day on that first video, and I did a little cleaning up afterwards, and a couple hours today, straightening that case, we're gonna get this thing going. things were not intended to be rebuilt. Entirely too expensive to replace. No tiller is worth replacing this chain case, because whatever messed up the first one can just as easily mess up the new one. And if you bounce it a couple times like I did, you count on messing it up. Honestly, I didn't bounce it that much, but when it started bouncing, I was a little bit annoyed, and I just let it bounce a couple times. Because these front-time tillers are a lot of work to use. And at the end of this video, I'm gonna show you why it took me 2 weeks to get back to this. To make this video so you could hear me, I had to turn off my fan, so I'm sweating like a whore in church. But really shouldn't take too long. Get this case back together. Get on back up here. Squeezing out. Proof we got some grease in it. And in case you're wondering if I'm worried about bending up this case, you should have seen it earlier. It was bent, ripped, cut through. Bit of a pain, but we'll get it done. I said before. I don't know anything about editing video, so this drags on. Just pulling fast to the part you want to see. Life, I was a carpenter. It shouldn't be kicking my ass like it is, but it is. I'm sweating up the handle. What is this? A hammer handle. Having a little trouble controlling it. Truly been tinkering with this for a couple hours now. Literally tinkering. This is what tinkerers do. The tinkerer's trade. Worksheet metal. Quite done yet. Give me a minute here. Still functioning as it should, so far so good. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn that fan on for a few minutes and just pound on this without talking, so you don't need to hear me.